In this video, I will introduce you to some must-have new Fallout 4 mods that are sure to heat up your gaming experience. I'll be focusing on mods related to locations and quests. And the first mod I'll introduce is Modding for Charity, Shady Motives with Wes Johnson. This quest mod features the renowned voice actor Wes Johnson.
It's all over, lawbreaker!
As the voice of the main character, and is created by the Sim Settlements team, Otolino, and the Concord Stories team. The quest begins when you enter and exit any building, and a Mr. Handy wearing a police hat approaches the player to start the quest. You'll discover a mysterious note, update your quest journal, and explore new dungeons provided by the Concord Stories team. The captivating voice acting and exciting storyline will add a thrilling dimension to your Fallout 4 adventure.
What seems to be the problem?
Next up is the Polaria Systems Dungeon mod, created by Vitaplex. This mod features an exploration of the secretive research facility known as Polaria Systems, established by visionary scientists and seers who anticipated a nuclear war. Players will delve into a vast dungeon overtaken by the gunners, filled with an array of machinery and experiments. Among the discoveries awaiting players is a new weapon, enhancing the immersive and realistic experience of Fallout 4. This mod promises to be an excellent addition for those passionate about mods, offering new challenges and excitement. Next up is Subway Runner, Revival. This mod is an enhanced version of the original Ghost FC3's Subway Runner mod, focusing on improved stability and compatibility. It connects 90% of the standard subway stations and creates a network of subway tunnels filled with raiders, super mutants, synths, and ghouls. With this mod, players can swiftly traverse the wasteland underground by eliminating enemies. Additionally, it has addressed various bugs by restoring nav mesh and fixing lighting errors, ensuring a more stable gameplay experience. Now, you can embark on a thrilling subway adventure with Subway Runner Revival. This time, I'd like to introduce some gameplay-related mods. First up is Pushkick F-Force Garden of Eden. This mod adds new kicking animations and functionalities to the game. It allows players to activate a pushkick by pressing the bash button while blocking, aiming, staggering, or during reload animations. The pushkick adds an additional 3 points of damage per force, capped at 30 points, and adds 0.5 points of damage per player level. Also capped at 30 points. If the target is not a large creature, it can induce maximum stagger. This strategic element can make the push kick quite useful, potentially making it a must-have mod for your collection. Next up is ClickLight, highlight objects clicked in console. This mod offers a feature that highlights objects selected through the console. It is particularly useful for modding experiences, as it visually emphasizes the selected object when using console commands to select specific items within the game, making it easier to identify for modifications or inspection. If you've ever experienced inconvenience while selecting item objects through the console, this mod will provide significant convenience. Next up is Stomp Attack F-Force Garden of Eden. This mod supports both first-person and third-person perspectives. The stomp attack is activated when the player's angle, X, is between 60 and 80 degrees, and the crosshair's target is in a bleeding, stunned, paralyzed, leg paralyzed state and has the allow stomp keyword. To execute the attack, press the bash power attack button. When not wearing power armor, the attack deals damage of 10 per unit of strength, capped at a maximum of 150 damage. With power armor equipped, it inflicts a base damage of 150. If the right leg is not broken, an additional 50 damage is dealt, and if there is an explosive vent, an extra 100 damage is inflicted. Additionally, 1 point of damage per player level is added, regardless of whether power armor is worn, up to a maximum of 100 damage. Next up is Fallout 4 Resound Project Guns. This mod encompasses over 1,400 sounds for both players and NPCs, offering an experience that surpasses the limitations of the game's audio engine. Each weapon utilizes 4 layers and 4 variations, ensuring that every gunshot sounds unique. When aiming, you can enjoy a more powerful and mechanical sound, which, combined with new reloading noises, creates the sensation of handling a brand new firearm. This time, I'd like to introduce the latest rifle mods, starting with the Warfighter's Owen Gun and the Fennec 45. Firstly, the Owen Gun may remind you of the Sten, but it's characterized by its top-loading magazine, and it's said to have been developed by Evelyn Owen around 1931. It offers custom reload animations, allowing for a unique reloading experience. When modifying this rifle, the design changes significantly. Especially notable is when equipping the drum magazine, which also alters the reload motion. The rate of fire is quite decent, and the overall sound of the gun is satisfactory. Using 10mm and 45 caliber ammunition makes this rifle quite useful in the early stages of the game. Next up is the Fennec 45, which may be quite familiar to those who enjoy playing Call of Duty. Its rapid fire rate makes it exceptionally effective in close quarters combat. It features a detachable stock, a drum magazine, or various muzzles, and the option to customize with a single type of scope. So if you prefer guns like the Vector, this rifle could also be a great choice for you. Next up is the 44 Auto-Revolver mod. This mod introduces the Italian-made Mateba Unica 6 revolver to the game. It includes new models, textures, and animations, adding diversity to Fallout 4's weapon collection. After reaching level 22, it's added to the loot lists of raider bosses, gunners, and shop inventories, and you can find several unique weapons at specific locations. I decided to introduce it particularly because of the high-quality first-person animations, which seem to accurately convey the feel of wielding the 44 revolver and its distinctive handling. The rather destructive gunshot sounds will likely make your Fallout 4 experience even more thrilling. Next up is the Select Throwing Knives mod. This mod adds throwable knives to Fallout 4, offering a dynamic animation effect when using the knives as your primary weapon. When drawing a knife, it spins elegantly in your hand, allowing for a stylish grip and attack on enemies. There's also a legendary version of the knives available from level 20, which can be thrown at enemies like grenades. This addition enriches the variety of throwable weapons and could enhance stealth gameplay with more thrilling elements. Lastly, I'd like to introduce a few outfit-related mods. First up is Tumbajamba's heavy shotgun and gunner armor. This mod includes not only armor, but also weapons. As shown in the video, the outfit and weapon come as a set. The weapon can be purchased from Proctor Teagan aboard the Pridwin, and starting from level 20, there's a chance that Gunners and Brotherhood of Steel members will drop it, so keep that in mind. Next up is Gen Ramen Hat. This mod features a cute hat adorned with black cat ears. The design is quite appealing, and I personally wanted to share it with you. When paired with a black outfit, it enhances your character's individuality, setting it apart from the typical dark vibe of regular hats. This hat adds a touch of cuteness, potentially upgrading the charm of your character. If you're fond of such a design concept for outfits, I encourage you to try it out for yourself. Thank you for joining us in this exploration of the latest Fallout 4 mods for the fourth week of June 2024. We hope you found some exciting additions to enhance your gaming adventures in the Commonwealth. Remember to subscribe for more updates on the latest mods and gaming content. See you next time, and happy modding!
What seems to be the problem?